This video is part one of two videos that describe the land chain simulation model Geomod. We illustrate the principles using data from the Plum Island ecosystem site in northeastern Massachusetts, which the National Science Foundation funds through its long-term ecological research network. Geomod requires at the minimum one map of presence versus absence in order to simulate the spatial allocation of chains over time. This is a map of presence versus absence of developed land at 2001. Non-developed land is green and developed land is red. We use this map as our initial land cover map to simulate the transition from non-developed to developed land over time. A land cover map from a second time point is not necessarily required for Geomod because Geomod simulates only the spatial allocation of chains. However, a map from second time point can be used to specify the quantity of chains. We use a map of developed versus non-developed land at 2011 to specify the quantity of chains. Both maps originate from the National Land Cover Database, which created the maps from satellite-based imagery. Geomod allows maps of driver variables to guide the spatial allocation. We use this map of 21 categories, which derive from aerial photography. The map comes from state of Massachusetts and shows categories at 1999. Each driver image must be categorical variable. If the variable is continuous, such as elevation or distance, then the variable must be bent into categories before a variable can be used in Geomod. Geomod is available as a module within the GIS software TerraSet. This slide shows the first dialog box. Start by specifying a parameter file for your project. We enter a project title, Geomod version 1, then click Create. The primary Geomod dialog box contains four tabs. The first tab is Simulation Specifications. Under Input Image, select your initial land cover map. We are using a map of Plum Island ecosystems at 2001. We use 2001 and 2011 as the beginning and ending times of our time interval, respectively. We choose a 10-year time step to calculate from 2001 to 2011 in one temporal jump. Next, we must choose which neighborhood search mode to use. With the unconstrained mode, Geomod chooses the pixel with the highest suitability values to simulate chains from non-developed to developed. We use the unconstrained mode for this Geomod run. The second Geomod tab is Suitability and Impact Analysis. You can choose either to create a new suitability image or to use an existing suitability image. We create our suitability image using Geomod. Next, choose the number of driver images you use and enter the file name of each. We are using a single driver image and thus its weight is 1. We do not create an environmental impact analysis for this example. The third tab is ending time quantities. There could be many ways to determine the quantity of simulated chains based on calculation outside of Geomod. Those quantities are input here. If you have no basis to compute the quantities, then Geomod allows you to use a reference image at the ending time to force Geomod to simulate the correct quantity of chains. We use this option for this example. Geomod automatically fills in the correct ending time number of pixels. The final tab is Output Specifications. Choose a prefix for your output images. We suggest that you save the Geomod parameters before hitting OK. Then click OK to run Geomod. Geomod produces a suitability map, which dictates the sequence in which Geomod selects pixel for simulated chains. Geomod created our suitability image by comparing the 21 categories of driver image to the map of developed land at the beginning time, which is 2001. Geomod computes an empirical probability for each category in the driver image, then uses the empirical probabilities to reclass the driver image to produce the suitability image. This figure derives from a comparison between the categories of the driver image and the beginning land use image. The total length of each stacked bar is the size of each driver category. The portion of the bar that is red is in the developed state at 2001. The numbers to the right of the red portion give the percent of the category that is developed at 2001. The empirical probability for each category is a ratio where the numerator is the length of portion of the bar that is red and the denominator is the length of the entire stacked bar. For example, 14% of forest at 1999 was in a developed state at 2001 and thus forest has a suitability value of 14. The land cover classes with the highest suitability values are outlined in blue. Geomod also outputs the map of simulated land cover at the ending time, which is 2011. The suitability map dictates the sequence in which Geomod selects pixels for the simulated gain of developed. Geomod selects the non-developed pixels that have the largest suitability values for the transition to developed until the quantity of pixels of the simulated chains matches the quantity specified. To compare the simulated chains to the reference chains from 2001 to 2011, we overlay three maps: the simulated land cover at 2011, the reference land cover at 2011, and the reference land cover at 2001. Light gray indicates correct rejections, meaning pixels where land remains undeveloped according to the both reference information and the simulation. Yellow indicates false alarms, meaning pixels where Geomod simulates chains but the reference information shows persistence. Blue indicates misses, meaning areas where Geomod simulates persistence but the reference information shows chains. Red indicates hits, meaning places where Geomod simulates chains correctly. Dark gray indicates areas that were already developed at 2001 and thus are not eligible to transition to develop during the simulation. This figure compares the 21 categories of the driver image to the map on the previous slide. We zoom in to see the categories where Geomod allocates chains. Yellow and red show where Geomod simulates chains. Dark gray shows how much of each category was not available for the transition from non-developed to developed land. Blue outlines the land covers that have the highest suitability values but relatively little land available to change from non-developed to developed. Geomod selects all pixels in these seven categories for transition to develop, thus these categories have zero misses and zero correct rejections. Geomod then allocates gain of developed in driver category with the next highest suitability values until the specified quantity of chains is reached. That category is participation recreation, which has a suitability value of 76. Notice that participation recreation has misses, hits, false alarms, and correct rejections. If you would like to learn more about Geomod, including how to use mask Astrera images, constraint mode, and multiple driver images, watch the next video in this series, Basics of Geomod for Land Chains Modeling Part 2. Please contact us for additional information.